Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul. I worship your holy.
Hi, I'm Jim Johnson. I'm 61. I'm a teacher at Peoria Notre Dame for almost 25 years. I've been married 35 years. I have 5 children. And I grew up on a farm in Illinois, the oldest of 10 children. My parents were Catholics. But despite having such a sheltered youth in my early 20s, I lost the faith that they gave me. And I went like 15 years really without faith. And really thought that was okay. Figured it was all kind of fairy tale stuff anyway. It wasn't really true. But something traumatic happened to me. My 8-year-old daughter got killed in a playground accident in 1989. And when that happened, I lost some of the cynicism and the intellectual pride that I had. But I still didn't have any faith. But I knew I needed faith. I didn't know how to get it. Fortunately for me, the Catholic Church had a way to bring faith to me. About 5 years after my daughter died in 1994, Catholic missionaries came to St. Philomena, neo-catechumenal way, and they announced the good news that Christ has broken sin and death. And when I heard that, I said, I need to listen. And not too long after that, I realized that I would never have listened to the gospel, to the good news, if I didn't have this tragedy with my daughter happen. So I began to understand the Paschal mystery, which is that Jesus Christ brings life from death, because he actually did that for me. He brought life for me, a faith life, from the death of my daughter, which translated into my life like this, and that it helped me understand my marriage. I was thinking, boy, doesn't I don't belong too good, maybe I made a mistake. But once I began receiving faith from the church, I realized that no, my marriage is something intended by God that is for my good and the good of her, and it's not an accident, even though it's not always perfect. And after a year or two in the church taught Liz and I something about children. And openness to life, and as a consequence of that, my youngest son Timothy was born. He's a senior here. So whenever I see Timmy, I know that Jesus Christ brings life from death, because he did precisely that in my family.
Hi, my name is Liz Johnson, and Sister asked me to share my faith experience. I came from a Catholic family. I was a cradle Catholic. I had 5 sisters and 3 brothers. My father was a New York City policeman, and we lived in New York City. It was very violent, so he decided to move us to Long Island. At that point, my family started to drift away from the church. In high school, I can honestly say that I hardly went to church. I didn't really have faith. And then I went to college at Florida Atlantic University, where I met Mr. Johnson. Okay, so we got married, and some years later, we had family, very tragic event. I lost my daughter, many of you know, Jennifer. She was killed on a playground. She was 8 years old. And this is the event that I can say absolutely brought me back to the church, brought me to my knees, broke me, and showed me how much I needed God in my life. I had to find God, because there was nothing left. So as a matter of fact, we left the hospital the day she was killed. We drove straight to a church where I met a very young, very kind priest named Father Patrick. And he was very generous with us, gave us a lot of his time. And at some point he helped us to call my mother-in-law, who didn't know the tragic news yet. I knew instantly that I had to call her, because she was a woman of very strong faith. And I knew instantly, instinctively, that I needed to call her. And so that was the beginning of my journey. Fast forward, it came time to send my oldest son, James, to school. And of course, school was a real scar for me because Jennifer was killed at school. So I went to all the schools pretty much in Peoria, and I met Sister Mary Joseph, who was so kind, so patient with me. That's where we began our faith journey. Once they were in school, the kindergarten teacher, Mrs. Berlinger, some of you might remember her, had very strong faith, and while she was teaching my children, I learned. And that's kind of where I re-entered the Catholic Church. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Tim Johnson. I'm a senior. I'd say the one thing that's most important to my faith in my life, or brought me to faith and most of my life, is probably my family. I've been raised up in a very faithful house. There's been lots of problems there. You know, I've seen a lot of struggles, and I guess and what I've been shown through my family, through my parents, what they've shown me, schools they put me through, and everything. I've seen that there's purpose to each struggle, and there's goodness in everything. That's one thing I really value, is the good in everything. And so, that's...
My parents were my inspiration, and I think the inspiration for my children as well. But my mom taught us how to say the rosary. My dad was the one that took the 10 of us kids to confession all the time as a family. Now you're really blessed to have confession on demand when you're here at the high school. My mother taught us how to say the rosary and the importance of the family rosary. When you would go off to college, she'd say, don't forget your rosary. And when you graduate from college, she'd say, don't forget your rosary. When you go off to your first job, it was, don't forget to be working your beads and saying the rosary. It's your sort of perseverance that you keep in your pocket with you all the time. My parents were the example of dying to self every day, self-sacrifice with 10 kids. We've got room for one more, we've got room for one more, another baby, and all the gifts that God gives you with each child that He brings you. And my parents were very open to life. And my mom gave a great visual when I was growing up. She said, every time you go to Mass outside of Sunday, it's a building block to heaven. It gets you closer to heaven every time you go to Mass outside of Sunday. And so to me, it was almost like seeing these steps that you would build to heaven every time you got to Mass outside of Sunday. To get those graces to fill your cup, to face the day, to ask forgiveness where you fall short. And that's all due to my parents and their parents before them. And I can only hope that my children are practicing carrying their rosary and using it, their sword of perseverance when they need it, and always be thankful for their gift of the Catholic faith, because it really is a gift.
I'm Grace. I'm a freshman here at Notre Dame. And my family really inspires me to grow in my faith through everything that they do. My mom really tries hard to pray whenever we can. Every time we get in the car, before we go anywhere, we'll always say a short prayer. And every time you would walk into my grandparents' house, you would almost always see my grandma praying the rosary. And she would always ask us if we wanted to pray with her. And I never really appreciated how much prayer is important to our faith until I went to a Steubenville conference. And on one of the nights there, we had a huge, huge thing of adoration, and you could feel the Holy Spirit there, and it was so amazing. And I finally realized how important it was for me to pray every day and try to be more like my grandma, who would pray the rosary, or to think more about what I was praying in the car.
I'm Jack Conley, I'm a junior, and something that's been important to me in my faith has actually been through school. It's been Man Club with Father Stimson. He got a bunch of guys together, and on Wednesdays we just kind of hang out and we discern our vocation, and he encouraged us to go to Mass on Wednesdays before we meet, and it's been really helpful for me to like keep things in perspective in the middle of the week when things are getting hectic and busy, let me see what's important, and help me keep things in focus.
Growing up, I've been very blessed. My mom has always kept us really involved with our faith, and really incorporating prayer just into everyday life. I'm always continuing to make sure that we are in touch with our faith in some way growing up, and always kept us in Catholic education, which really made a huge difference. But for me, I think my kind of like aha moment was last year. I had the opportunity to go on a focus mission trip, and I traveled to Lima, Peru. And while there, I had the opportunity to build a house for a single mother with three kids, one of them who had a mental handicap. You know, you go there thinking that you're going to spread Christ wherever you go and that it's going to be, you're going to be helping these people. But you come back so blown away because while you may have touched these people, they have affected you in a way you can't even imagine. And I feel like they touched me with their faith even more than I ever could for anyone. And actually because of that, me and my best friends returned for a month this summer and worked in a children's camp. For children who may be in abused homes or just are struggling, and just really being able to be there for other people who are so joyful even in the situations that they are in. And while we may think that we have hardships here, just seeing what they go through every day, it really, really was truly a blessing to get to work with them. And it all comes back to my mom and how she's always continued to push us to be involved with those things. And without her and her support, I never have had those experiences. So it's really, truly a blessing to have grown in my faith through her.
I don't think that my faith journey was necessarily something that was a wow moment that I had, but my biggest thought in this process has been my grandparents, who were very devout on both my mom and my dad's side, and I shared a lot of time with them growing up, and their fidelity to the church and devotion to the church and their faith was very inspiring for me as a young child, and it was contagious. I just felt like it was something that I wanted myself. And I can remember really from a young age being excited for Sunday Mass. I always knew that's what I wanted. I wanted to have that relationship with Christ and to follow Him in every area of my life. I also had very devout parents, and every sacrament growing up, I'm the youngest of six, every first Holy Communion, confirmation, was a huge celebration. And my parents made it a beautiful day for us. I also met my spouse, who was also really devout to the faith, and I think our relationship grew really because of our faith. We were very attracted to each other because of our faith, and we want nothing more for our children than for them to love God with all their heart and to seek His will in every area of their life. We really feel like there's nothing more important, and our happiness is doing God's will. So that was our hope for our children and our family, and we continue to pray for that.
I've grown up in a really Catholic family, and my parents have done a great job of raising us in the faith and really make sure that the faith is a part of our lives. Two summers ago, I went to camp in Colorado, and the week I was there really like meant a lot to me because I like saw how much joy the people got from God and what God had given them and just the joy that they like could show. And I realized how much I wanted that in my life and how I needed the faith to be a part of my life and to choose it for myself wherever I go in life, that I needed to keep that with me because that would bring me the most joy.
Being raised in a Catholic family, my parents have given me opportunities to really discover my faith. And one of these was a camp that I went to in the Rocky Mountains. While I was there, one of my counselors gave a talk on finding our vocation and the plan that God has for each of us. And the best way to discover that plan is to grow in holiness. And so coming back from that camp, and since then, I've really tried to grow in personal holiness by coming to the sacraments as often as I can. After confirmation, I really tried to keep a connection with my confirmation saint, to be praying to him and asking for his help. And then going to the Eucharist as often as I can to receive God's grace. And when I fall, getting the confession as soon as possible and making regular confessions so that I can continue to receive the grace from God.